Western United States. The stories of his strength and courage, his daring and resourcefulness have come down to us through the generations. And nowhere in the pages of history can one find a greater champion of justice. Return with us now to those thrilling days of yesteryear. From out of the past to the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse Silver. The Lone Ranger rides again.
Come on, Silver! Let's go, big fellow!
It was just before midnight, in the deep shadows near the corral of the big Rafter-M ranch. A figure moved quietly toward a man who stood there in the darkness. Suddenly, the man felt the unmistakable prod of a gun barrel at the back of his neck.
Say, what the...
Don't move, Whitey.
Why, you... Kelly. Jim Kelly, the nester.
Put your arms behind you. I've got a double noose here that'll just fit your wrist.
You can't...
I said put them behind you.
You... That's better. Listen, Nestor, you won't get away with this.
Think I'm doing all right so far? Open your mouth. I've got a gag.
I won't let...
Yes, you will. Very spry for a special gun hand who's been hired to keep me away from Nora Mather. I'll see you later. No light in Nora's room. Maybe she's asleep. I'll toss some gravel.
I've been waiting and hoping.
Haven't much time to talk, Nora. Is your pa awake?
I think he's still up in the front room reading.
Good.
But that man he hired, Whitey, he's liable to be around sometime.
Not anymore. Whitey's gagged and tied up down by the corral. A good job. I did it myself.
Oh, Jim.
I've got a lot to tell you, Nora, and not much time to say it.
What do you mean?
I'm in trouble. Sheriff rode over to my farm tonight to serve that warrant your pa swore against me for fighting with his foreman.
I knew he was going to do that, Jim.
Wait, the warrant is only the beginning.
Well,
about 10 minutes after the sheriff left my place, he was shot and killed on the trail. Murdered.
Oh.
You know what that means. They'll all blame me. Just because I'm a farmer in cattle country, every cowman around here will swear that a nester killed the sheriff.
You didn't do it, Jim, and they'd have to prove it.
What chance would a farmer have before a jury of cattle races? I know there's only one thing I can do. That's why I came over. Say goodbye.
Jim, you're not going to run away.
Either that or stay here and be railroaded for a crime I didn't commit. You know what the situation is, Nora, and I don't stand a chance.
But you and I, we planned so much.
I'll come back. Or send for you. As soon as I get a start someplace else. And...
If you leave, I'm going with you.
Nora.
If you want me to.
Want you? What else have I been working for? But, Nora, you'd better think it over. Means a definite break with your father.
I've thought of all that a million times. Here, help me through the window.
But shouldn't you take something with you? Extra clothes or...
We'll stop by the widow Mason's place. She'll loan me anything I need.
Good. Then we'll borrow another horse. Ride over to the county seat first thing in the morning and be married.
Oh, darling.
Come on. My horse's ground hits the other side of the corral. We can leave...
Look out, Jim. That ring bell with the pail right in front of you.
What the...
Dad didn't hear.
What's going on down there? Why, is that you?
Oh, yes,
only thing to do now is run for it. Here's my horse. Steady, boy. Give me a hand, or I'll help you up.
Nester Jim Kelly's saddle horse. By Juniper Tears. She's running away with that farmer. Whitey! Where's Whitey?
I don't know.
Come on over to the bunkhouse. I want every puncher we've got to roll out and hit the leather.
Sure, boss. Anything you say.
What's happened? That daughter of mine. She's run off with Jim Kelly, the Nester.
Well, I'll be... We'll get the boys up pronto.
Come on, hurry. Let's get him out of the bunkhouse. Hurry up.
You're hit with the boss, then. Roll out!
Rafter-M corral. They hadn't been riding hard because Tonto's horse carried a double load. The body of a dead man was slung across his saddle.
Easy, big fella. This is a good-sized ranch, Tonto. I may be able to get the information we want. You wait here.
Kimasabe.
What is it?
See over there by corral. Man on the ground.
Well, I don't. Yeah, you're right. No, but he's bound and gagged. Show me your knife, Tonto. Thanks. There, he got the gag.
Masked. An owl hoot. What are you doing here?
Same question applies to you. What's the name of this ranch?
Rafter-M. I work here.
With a gag in your mouth and your hands tied behind you?
It was that sneaking master, Jim Kelly. Slipped up behind me, put a gun in my ribs. But the murdering skunk won't get away with it. Any more than he'll get by with killing a lawman down on the river trail tonight. And coming up here and running away with Walt Mather's daughter.
Hmm. I didn't know there anyone.
How come a freebooter like you
would answer that later?
Hey, wait.
Hold up, boss. Whitey. Whitey. What in thunderation happened to you?
About 20 minutes ago, I was keeping my eye on the main road, like you told me, when Kelly, the nester, came up and put a gun in my back.
Kelly, huh?
So it was him.
Sneaking little child.
What is this thing out, Whitey? Me or some of the boys that have hurt
you?
He's got a gag in my mouth. Tied my hands.
How'd you get loose?
An owl hoot cut me loose about 2 minutes ago.
Owl hoot?
A big hombre wearing a black mask. I don't know where
you're supposed to be a professional gunslinger. That's why I hired you. So what happened? You get drunk. Let a dirt-scratching sodbuster sneak in here and run off with my daughter.
I wasn't drunk.
Have some local talk about an owl hoot wearing a black mask.
Oh, I tell you, he was just here.
Ah, shut up. You haven't got enough gumption to stuff a pipe.
Maybe we better stand out. Search the barn.
Already wasted too much time.
Boss, Whitey wouldn't
say anything. Anyway, you're supposed to be the ramrod, foreman around this place. But you let Jim Kelly sneak in.
I'm asleep.
If you ask me, you're asleep most of the time. Hey, some of you around a hand, pick up my buckboard. Saddle your horses.
All right, boss. What are you going to do, boss?
Going after my daughter and the polecat who's with her.
Yeah, Kelly's place ain't so far from here. We ought to be able to...
You think they'll head for his farm, do you?
Why, where else would they go?
Ray, it's a good thing you know something about steers. So you ain't got any sense about women.
Here's the buckboard.
I can't figure where they
go. I don't want to know that nester ride away from here double on his horse.
He weren't carrying anything.
There ain't a woman living who'll go very far without extra clothes.
You think that they...
Sure, and all stop and see the nearest woman friend she's got. That'd be the Widow Mason. So that's where we're heading. You and Whitey scramble your bronc. 3 or 4 the rest of you come.
Hey, just saw something else, Mr. Mather.
Now what?
That Kelly Aubrey is one of the leaders among the nesters. This might stir them all up. Start a range war.
What do I care? Nora's my daughter. And I say she's not going to marry a sodbuster. Come on, let's ride. Get up.
Running off with a nester, eh?
We're going to be married.
Oh, no, you're not. Ray, you and Whitey grab that sock, but
Ray, right, just a minute. You're not grabbing anybody.
Yeah, I've got the gun this time, Nestor.
Now, wait. There'll be no gunplay in my house.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Mason, but this is a situation that calls for action.
I agree with you.
Oh, well, I'll be... What's wrong with all of you?
Behind you, Whitey. You just walked in the back door.
And you'd better hold to that gun, Whitey, before you turn around.
What? The mask on me.
The same one.
What's the matter with you two? Gonna let an outlaw bluff you? Gun him down.
Hey there. I mean, he's got the drop on him.
I'm not packing a gun, but there's four punches outside the wire. He can't hold a drop on everybody. Hey, boys! Take out your hardware and come in here.
I wanted with a few words with you, Jim.
Me?
But we'd better do our talking where it isn't so crowded. Quick, back of me and out this door.
But I don't want to go.
I'm giving the orders, whether you like it or not. Out that door, and don't any of you move.
Boys, come in here.
Listen, you can't.
Yes, I can. Out that back door. A masked outlaw. And he took the Nestor with him.
Now, stay. Lock. Hold it from the other side.
Oh, Jim. What have they come of
him? Take it down. Smash it. And gun those critters.
Exciting scenes, please permit us to pause for just a few moments. Continue our story. Forcing his unwilling prisoner to run ahead of him by the threat of his gun, the Lone Ranger raced for the crackling color of a small grove of trees.
Wait, I don't want to get away from here. Nora's back,
oh, and I'll keep low and run. Head for those trees.
But my horse is in front of the house.
No, he isn't. I brought him around here. Quick, take your spurs and ride.
Hey, Silver,
here.
Didn't expect to be away as long as... I was right. see what we're doing. What you look for, Kemosabe?
I don't know. That's the trouble.
The ward notices first, I guess. Here's a whole door full. This will take a little time to look through all of these.
Oh,
Toby. And no sign of those dirt scratchers who were going to start
the lift. Here they come. They spotted them, too.
Yeah. I don't know how that Kelly kid happened to be here. I don't care. Those sod busters asked for war, and that's what they're going to get.
Break out your guns, boys.
Ready for them, boys. Yokel friends to fill her hands.
I think you've seen one thing you've overlooked here at Crown Point.
Yeah?
Look down there in the draw, the other side of those trees. It's a corral with about 200 head of stock in it. Rafter-M stock.
What? Right, boss. I can see him through that break in the trees.
Looks like every steer that's ever been rustled from our herd.
You're right. Well, of all the concerned gall, you've got nerve enough.
I didn't steal the stock. Neither did any other farmer. That's why we wanted you up here to prove
that. Don't waste time talking to that murdering stuff. Let's gun him down, all of them.
Yeah,
I'll do the first man who reaches for a gun.
What's that? Look, boss, on top of the bluff. The masked hombre who... And the redskin.
What?
Nobody's stopping me.
Ow!
Get out of here! Oh!
I don't care how many I'll host aside you. We'll take on the whole pack of you.
I don't think you will, Mr. Matthews.
When you know the truth.
Yeah. What's that?
Where's Jim Kelly been if those cowpunchers haven't been holding him?
Jim's been with me ever since we left the Widow Mason's house yesterday afternoon.
And what's the idea of that engine over there?
Jim has already explained the reason for that message. We wanted to be sure every farmer from the flats and every cowman from the Rafter-M would be here.
Now, it doesn't make sense. They've rustled my stock. It's all down there in that corral.
No, the farmers haven't stolen a single head of your cattle. Two men have done that systematically for 2 or 3 months. One of those men is on your payroll.
I don't believe it.
The other one is dead. He was Sheriff Conroy.
Yeah. Conroy?
He was murdered when Whitey found out the sheriff intended to double-cross him.
Whitey? You mean
he's alive?
Watch out, Mr. Mathers. He's got a high-out shot.
I expected that from you, Whitey.
You broke my hand. You slugged right through my hand.
You're lucky it wasn't your head.
Jim Kelly. Lucky. If he hadn't moved in front of me...
You're right, Mr. Mathers. Jim's quick thinking saved your life.
I don't know what to say.
How about it, Jim? Is your wound serious?
No. Scraped my shoulder. I'll be all right.
So Whitey's been double-crossing me all the time.
Yes, here's proof of it. A letter to Sheriff Conroy from a cattle buyer below the border. He mentions his hideout corral. He agrees with Conroy that there's no sense in splitting the profits three ways.
Well, I'll be... How did you know Whitey was tied up with the sheriff?
I didn't. All I knew was that Whitey had murdered Conroy.
Well, how'd you know that? We all thought...
Because Tom and I found Whitey bound and gagged last night and released him. The first thing he did was accuse Jim Kelly of murder. At that time, no one else knew about the killing.
The thieving skunks sure had us all fooled. I've always thought the nesters were the ones.
They've always thought that they couldn't get a square deal from cattlemen. You've both been mistaken.
Yep, I can see it now.
I'll leave word with the United States Marshal in the next county to come over and take charge of Whitey. You'll hold him till then, won't you?
Yeah, don't worry. The varmint won't get away from us.
Good. Ready, Tonto?
You ready?
Men, Silver,
get out! Come.
Well, I'll be doggone. Jim, the biggest mistake I've made is about you. Yeah, Nora was right.
Well, that man in the mask helped me to stretch.
How about riding back to the Rafter-M for supper? Give Nora a chance to fix a meal for a smart young fella and a dad-burned old fool.
Sure.
Let's ride.
Easy, boy.
All right, fellas, let's go. Get up.
Thank you.
Herd is a copyrighted feature of the Lone Ranger Incorporated.